Welcome, Disc Golf World. Today, we're at Shoaff Park in Fort Wayne, Indiana. My friend Cody SENGTHONG, who's in the video, is getting married. This is basically Labor Day weekend. We're going to be calling this the SENGTHONG Union IPFW Reunion Battle. All three of us went to IPFW back when it was called IPFW. This will be a combined score of their team versus my single score. And we're going to do 2-off-1. Let's get it.
2-off-1.
Cody the Sang Banger is going to be starting here with his red katana. Up the middle, but gets a little turn to the right. Pretty good distance, though. He wanted to fade out at the end there.
But then we live.
Okay. This is Albert Klimek. Looks like he's throwing his Pro Destroyer. Good flat release. Just hyzers out a little shy of the basket.
Yeah, because this one's going long.
Mm-hmm.
I believe this is Cody's other red katana. He's got a stack of champion katanas he likes to use. Albert's biting off that line as well. That's his Millennium Falcon. Good glide on that. Comes back, but not quite enough left to have a look at it. Here's myself. This is a Glow PD3, stable 11 speed. Taking it around the outside, trying to crash at the basket. Pretty well done.
Just short.
I'm gonna try to mimic that line, this time with a PD. It's too low out of the hand, not really a chance to work. We're playing pretty early in the morning and this grass is just saturated by, I'd say 3-4 holes in where you had soaking wet shoes. At least Albert and I know Cody was wearing some Gore-Tex, so. Albert slings one up there, no problem. Here's Cody coming in here with his banger. Matches the hillside nicely. Here I am coming down the hill a little bit. A little right side, but I catch the first birdie there. At this point of the round, I'm thinking I'm gonna be shooting a record round. We'll just have to see.
You shouldn't really do much zoom here.
Hole 2, 212. Just gonna get around this tree here.
Go.
Which I do not do. Just pummel the branches and
the door's open.
Fall straight down. This is usually one of the easier holes, but just how thick this tree is nowadays, it's kinda touchy. I believe Cody's throwing in his zone here. Looks like a Z line. I don't know if they call them Z line. Z zone? Z flex? I don't know. It's a new disc Albert's got, I gave him. It's a Star Firebird. Just kind of rips it over a little bit, but he's working on that shot. He's not a forehand specialist just yet. Gives it a solid smooth bid there. Not too greedy with it. Trying to make up for the tee shot, don't quite get it. Cody, just a little too nose down out of the hand there. See if Bert the shooter can make amends. Nope, same thing. These higher baskets are causing a little bit of trouble early. Getting up to hole 3. This one's a low ceiling, 262-foot uphill shot. I will also add, as I catch that last set of guardian trees, ground is very wet today. The grass is super sticky, so you can't really play the skip game. Gotta get it there in the air.
Good distance.
Cody rips his PD up there very nicely. That's an excellent shot for this hole. Just trying to avoid the trees altogether. Albert plays the safe hyzer out left. Smart shot. Tries to squeeze through the gap, doesn't quite get it. That would have been a good time for that forehand.
Oh god, it's fun. Terrible. Oh, you land in the same spot?
Yeah. There you go.
Sang banger, good extension, keeps the foot behind the lie. Well done. That'll get him going for the round. Ooh, unusual miss from the simple person. Here's hole 4, we're going way back up the hill. It's Cody ripping over on his katana. A little bit too much. Maybe he'll find the sweet spot a little later in the round. Kind of forced over a cloud breaker lightly. I don't want to blow past the basket, but...
You'll be pin high up there. Maybe a little further.
It's kind of a newer disc to me at that point, and I was just enjoying throwing it. Probably would have done better with a fairway driver. There's a Millennium Falcon out of Burt. This is Glow Buzz. Off to the right side, but fades in nicely. Give him a look. Beautifully executed. That's his signature SENGTHONG banger Anheuser upshot. Just shy on my attempt. It's probably just outside the circle there. Simple bird, just not really finding the rhythm. I know this is early in the day. We are a little jittery, had a few coffees this morning.
Nice, Cody. Oh. I thought it was it.
The SENGBANGER flexing over his Tesla doesn't quite get it to hold. I just kind of ripped this over. I don't even know what I'm doing at this point. Looks like he was trying to flex over his Pro Destroyer. Aggressive move. He knows what he's doing. Excellent laser upshot with that shield. I believe it's a West Side BT soft or medium shield. It's a signature disc, one of his. Trying to give this one a little bit of an attempt, but doesn't quite sink. There's a look at that shield for you. This one, you get a Mando on that tree to the right where you can see that white stake. Cody rips it up the center nice, but catches some low debris hanging off of that tree. That's unfortunate. Only something that happens in summer. It's me ripping a spider, just missing the Mando there. Very, very terrible shot. Smooths the gap to the left, playing out safe, not even bringing the Mando into question. Here's my flippy wizard, just kind of trying to give a soft bid without going too long. Going uphill here, so you can kind of give it a little juice. Cody's signature Anheuser banger into the green lands nicely. Medium dagger sitting up nice. Very nice putt. That's a bogey for
ball game last night. Embarrassing.
Runs that one in. He's just a few putts off really being lights out right now. Cody catching a little more foliage. He's just a little bit off today.
Oh.
I told him what to do there and he got mad, so I let him throw again. And it looks like he had the same idea. I don't know what he's thinking, but we'll see how it plays out. See, I used to go soft fairway driver and it's just too far.
Putt and bay.
I believe that was his signature shield. Fortunate for Cody to catch some of that foliage on the way in, or he'd definitely have a good putt. So I have a peculiar lie. I was kind of wedged under the log where I didn't have a good stance and just a little shy on the bid. Let's see if he can get something going here.
Good putt.
There you go.
Way to keep it.
Yeah, it's good. Beautiful. Plates, dog leg right, 265. Pretty good, decent climb of uphill. Cody's going for the sneaky inside gap. Nice, banks Cody. Off the tree. Manages just to get over there.
Yeah,
might have a look.
And then like keep it on that Anheuser.
Trying to force over a Millennium Falcon here. Getting a little sneaky there for Simple Bird. Kicks out nicely.
Pastry dies. Ricky Wysocki, Destroyer.
Yep.
Star Destroyer.
Two-time world champion.
New disc I got over in Kansas City. It's about what I wanted.
Have like a 50 footer from over.
West side, baby.
Again, calling out that West Side disc. You know, he is sponsored by this, not the company, but just the West Side Shield.
Just playing safe.
Cody with a good up. At this point, I'm pretty dejected, but just gonna keep playing. Birdies will come.
Ready, Brett?
Set of pars from the crew. Looks like we're forcing over a champ Firebird here. Right idea, just gets chopped down a bit early.
Channel Paul Macbeth.
McAlbert. Simple Bert.
McBert.
This is Simple Bert.
See what he's going for here. Oh my.
Can you say gap city, bitch?
Watch out. Simple Bert seems to be finding a groove with his buzz. This could be dangerous on this wooden stretch. Here's me hoping I can get my glow mortar down to match. Cody first strike. Looks about 40, 43 feet.
Yeah.
Just hangs on to it a little bit. Simple Bert starting to get a little rhythm going. That's what we expect from him. Little shaky there. The confidence out of Simple Bert is maybe getting to me. Yeah, luck's about to turn. Got a little sneaky on hole B. I say, it looked like he was flexing over his zone. Could have been his rock. Rock three. Trusty glow buzz out of Albert. Not biting off too much. Just elects to go right at the tree. Good effort there. Good bit of uphill climb on this one. I think that might be what's getting Simple Bert. Most of his courses in Simple, Illinois are pretty flat.
God, his ass. They didn't record it on purpose.
Forehand, you know, FD3 is just a little flippier than the Firebird I mostly use, but was giving it a try today.
Fuck yeah, Cody.
Believe that's the C-line PD2 out of Cody SENGTHONG there. Well done. You know, that's a solid shot right there. If you remember earlier, he had a little trouble with that Firebird, but that one came out nice and saucy. Here's a Luster PD2. Looks like we're going with a cut roller.
Dude.
Just watching a video the other day, Scott Stokely demonstrating a different way to throw that shot with a putter. Saying that cut rollers on approaches are wrong. And you know what? I think I agree with him. I gotta get out and practice that. Albert tosses up to the basket. Cody a little obstructed here, but definitely in the wheelhouse. Hits a dead center. Very nice. Little Simple Bert cleanup here. Oh, yeah.
Yeah! Oh.
At this point, I know that Albert's gonna start getting a lot of birdies. Barely climb over the basket. Got four tiers of bars on that basket. The Firebird forced over flex there. Very nicely done. Only 191 feet here. It's all about the angle.
There you go. There you go.
It says, monkey see, monkey do.
There you go, Bernie.
That's what I was trying to do, bro.
Trying the same thing, too.
That'll come out.
Happy to get through after their success.
Yeah, we're off there.
Bert from the jungle here. Ooh. I took the walk to Poland. Hurdles the fallen log and cashes a nice putt on
D. Basket D.
Taking my time there. Get it over the bars. See, Cody's feeling a lot of pressure now. Hopefully he doesn't get big putted. No, he's finding a groove
yeah,
as well.
Cody.
Give the old European shake. Moving on to hole E. Got a turnover, a forehand up the hill, only 171 feet. Got to cross those two large trunks over there that Cody played by, and you'll have yourself a putt. Still working on that forehand. Same Firebird. Aww. He's trying to find his angles. It's a new shot for him, new disc for him as well. Somewhere for me, I'm trying to find my angles with this FD3. Looks like I got it this time.
Yeah, he's parked.
It's not a pop on that one, but he's not too mad about it.
Oh no.
Just shy. Lasers that one in there. Confident stroke. Couple deep breaths, good arm extension. Starting to find my putt. Feet here, got a little backboard to play to. Touchy gap, very gettable birdie though. He rips over on his banger just a touch too much. He needs to start that on a little more hyzer. You know, I like this play. Some ground action with a buzz. That's Albert Klimek's style right there. He keeps it simple. Good jump putt right there. Great line, just a little short. It's probably the first jump putt Albert's ever tried. So, for that, decent effort. All right, dead center. We're coming out to the open now.
Here you go.
Yep. Hooking back up on hole 9, 207 feet. It's the scene of, I believe, two of Cody's aces back in the day. Used to be another tree, kind of left side deep fairway. But now this shot's wide open. Takes his Comet and goes way wide with it. Excellent. Here's Albert taking his H3. Get a hyzer just inside the tree out to the left side fairway. Smart shot. Pulls out his medium dagger. Goes for a classic Polish pull peg.
There you go, Bert.
Smart upshot. Sticks tight to the basket. And here we are cleaning up our birdies. Huh? Solid drives out of Cody and myself. Ripping a PD2 out here. That's really all I can say about that one.
Oh, sorry, guys.
Cody ripping over on his katana here. Very nice flight. Fades out pretty tight to the basket. I'll give him a look.
This is a Millennium Falcon.
And who are you?
I'm Simple Bert.
Gotta clear the runway. We got the Millennium Falcon coming in. Hide your kids, hide your wife. Millennium Falcon is coming in.
Shit.
Bert! Look!
Yo, you launched almost over the road.
Solid upshot with the west side shield. From the tree, I give it a good run. No dice. Oh, he's gonna want that one back. Hole 11, 278. Pretty wide open on the left side here. Just trying to avoid that 15 mile per hour speed limit sign. Looks like I do so nicely with my PD3, glow PD3. Cody's gonna try the same line. This looks like it's either his Firebird or his PD2. I know he leans on both of those for forehands, stable forehands. Good rip on that. It looks like a Pro Destroyer. Laser beam in the shield at it. Very good attempt there. The Polish Prince has a very unique style of upshot. Very hard driven, low to the ground. Yeah, same disc, just going forehand here. It's a little shorter. Good. No, I can reach it with my forehand. Good. Cody, this is definitely the Firebird.
Yo.
Yeah, he gets that Firebird ground action on the road. Luckily, no car was in sight. Albert's going to try to bite off a little bit of that. Ooh. Really some good distance on that. He's just yanking it over a little bit. Heiser in just before the tree. Should settle with a, I think it's going to be a bogey. We're going to be giving him the OB stroke. Cody's just off the mark. So close to being on with a lot of these putts today. Hole 13, 256. I'm ripping over my PD3 again. Guess I'm in a little groove with it. I think that's up there. Looks a little shy here, but I believe from remembering the round, it was closer than it looks.
Nice.
And this is on a great line. I believe that's the PD2. Still working on the forehand skills, but I keep working on that with him. He's an ex-volleyball player. I want to say ex-volleyball player. Still a current volleyball player. And quite similar to a spike is the forehand. Just got to change the angle. Line driving right into the right side basket. Whew. Nice putt from the Pollock. There you go, good extension. 290. I read the T sign and tossed the little baby shot up there. That's my champion PD. Here's Cody, tossed it on his Tesla. Flipping it up to flat, just a little low, but might have a look at it. Here's Albert Klimek. He's going with his Pro Destroyer. Trying to get a big hyzer in. Just comes out of the hand a little bit early. See if you can get it together in these open shots. Gives it a bit of a run with the shield there. Very nice approach with that shield. Cody SENGTHONG pulling on his banger here, looks about 45 feet. Good height on it, just veers off a little early left. Myself managed to get one go from about 40 feet. So this was the last hole that Albert used the four-finger grip. Both of these players are known for their two-finger backhand grip. And Albert said, you know what, I'm switching back to it for this hole, so you'll get to see that here. I've been trying to tell him to use four. I'm going to throw my cloud breaker. I'm trying to hyzer around that tree there on the right side of the screen, but I managed to catch it. Really thought I executed well, but not quite. There's a low-driving katana flipping over a bit, but looks like it fades out nicely at the end. We got a two-finger Millennium Falcon.
There you go, Bert. There you go, Bert. Nice launch.
You're out there.
Gets out there pretty good. Cody with his signature Anheuser banger upshot. Just a low laser. Managed to cash a nice one with a high lob. Oh, what's this? I'm getting a spin back. Cleaning up their pars is Albert and Cody. Total scores, -2 to -11. Hole 16, 390. They're pretty much the same shot as the last hole. There's just no tree in the way.
Dude,
finish up there nicely. Should have a look. Cody's going to his katanas, red katana.
Nice.
Good turn out of it. Good solid flight.
Sexy.
Now, if I didn't say it earlier, Cody is coming off of foot surgery. He broke his big toe on his, I believe, his right foot. So he's been a little weak on his, you know, approach and everything since then, understandably so, which is affecting his driving distance. Here's Albert taking an approach with his shield.
That's pretty good.
He's out about 20 feet left. Here's Cody with his Z-line zone. Putting up there pretty close to the basket. Nice shot. Here I am coming back from maybe circle's edge. Good. Not quite the effort we're looking for. Bert the shooter jams one in there. So this is a Luster P2. Really just the wrong disc. Felt the right left wind again, but should have learned from hole 10. Cody's trying to play a little more inside. I believe this might be his PD.
I can still make that putt.
Two-finger pro destroyer from Albert. Really almost perfect, I think. Just a few more feet of height to let that fade closer to the basket. But he's going to give it a run. Here's his medium dagger. Hip shot. Just gives it a little too much. Cody lobs it in there. Very good attempt. I mean, Cody's been just barely off the mark. It's heartbreaking to see. And here's me barely missing another one too, but luckily I got a good lead, so just trying to get my pars and get out of here. Yeah. Final hole, 236 uphill, plays a lot longer.
Short.
Forehanding a PD2 up there. Looks like it landed good. Here's Cody working on a new tilt he got. He had this for about 3 days before he lost it.
So it doesn't go right.
So Bert, this is his D2, I think, first showing this disc today. One of his more stable drivers has got in his bag.
That wasn't your rush? Okay.
Very nice putt there. I feel bad for Cody. He has been all over it. Simple Bert is going back to his simple skin. See, he needs about 5 minutes of sun a day. Any more than that, and he will burn. Here I am trying to close the day off with a birdie. And that's just how it goes. Looks like Simple Bird is done. Pack it in, he says. We're off. Final scores -11 to -1. Until next time, thanks for watching.